Welcome to Loyola House's celebration of Palm Sunday. If you've been here on retreat, you know that we would be ordinarily gathering in the lounge to begin this liturgy, and then we would go outside for the procession with the palms. But because of all of our need for healthy time with creation, we're beginning outside, and we are outside St. Francis Chapel now. And we're going to proceed with receiving our palms, but first Eric is going to tell us a little bit about the precision of Jesus's timing on this day.
Thank you, Yvonne. The question is, why did Jesus choose to enter Jerusalem on this particular day? And the answer is, because this was the day that Pilate entered Jerusalem from Caesarea Maritima. I used to think he lived in Jerusalem, but the center of administration was actually in Caesarea. And so every year, on this day especially, when there was a great celebration in Jerusalem, Pilate made certain to come in with a great show of military force, with trumpets and drums, with chariots, horses, himself riding a great horse, which is the beast of war. And knowing this, Jesus chooses this very same moment to enter Jerusalem from the east, coming down from the Mount of Olives, not riding on a horse, but on a donkey, the beast of burden for the poor man. And he comes with his disciples, who are greeting him as Messiah. And Jesus allows this in public for the first time. So this is Jesus as Messiah entering Jerusalem to take claim of the holy city as its king. He then goes immediately into the Temple Mount, challenges the chief priests, who are in charge of that. It is they, not the money changers and the sellers, who have made it a den of thieves. Jesus clears them out and then goes away.
The crowds that rejoiced and sang Hosanna, celebrating Jesus' entry into Jerusalem, used common palm branches that grow naturally around Jerusalem. You probably don't have access to that today. So I invite you to find a branch with maybe a bud on it, or some leaves, or an evergreen sprig out in your yard, or maybe there's something on your house plant. Some plant might be obliging to give you a branch to symbolize this time for you. And if you want to take some time to do that before you carry on with this video, you can do that. When you gather your branch, or before you gather it, consider how you want to enter into Holy Week. How do you want to be with Jesus this week? As you pray with the moments of his suffering, his dying, and his rising, who do you want to be for Jesus in this time? Another way to put it is, what is the grace you desire this week? Take a moment in prayer and ask for that grace. Ask to be able to be with Jesus the way you want, and to be with the suffering that is in our world with this pandemic this week. That is part of the Passion this week. So take a moment and pause the video if you want to take that moment now, and reflect on what it is you desire. Now, I invite each of us gathered here, and you, to name the grace we are praying for, you are praying for, in a few words, a short phrase, as you take up your branch. this week, and deep trust in God, especially in these fraught times in our world. And I pray to see the face of Christ in everyone I meet, especially those who are struggling, who are in pain, who might be angry, who might have frustration or short tempers, to especially see the face of Christ in those for whom this is hard.
I pray to be present to Christ humble in the world, and to realize how Christ is present in my humility.
Pray to be with Jesus the healer. Healing is so desperately needed by so many these days. Dear brothers and sisters, since the beginning of Lent until now, we have been preparing our hearts by penance and charitable works. Today we gather to herald with the whole church the beginning of the celebration of the Lord's Paschal Mystery, that is to say, of his passion and resurrection. It was to accomplish this mystery that he entered his own city of Jerusalem. Therefore, with all faith and devotion, let us commemorate the Lord's entry into the city for our salvation, following in his footsteps, so that being made by his grace partakers of the cross, we may have a share also in his resurrection and in his life. Let us pray. Almighty, ever-living God, sanctify these branches with your blessing, that we who follow Christ, the King, in exaltation, may reach the eternal Jerusalem through him, who lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. A very large crowd spread their cloaks on the road, and others cut branches from the trees and spread them on the road as well. The crowd that went ahead of him and that followed were shouting, "Hosanna to the Son of David! Blessed is the one who comes in the name of the Lord! Hosanna in the highest heaven!" When Jesus entered Jerusalem, the whole city was in turmoil, asking, "Who is this?" The crowds were saying, "This is the prophet Jesus from Nazareth in Galilee." The Gospel of the Lord. Dear brothers and sisters, like the crowds, claim Jesus in Jerusalem. Let us go forth in peace.
We invite you now to read the readings for the day on your own, including the Passion reading. That's what makes this Passion Sunday and prepares us to walk Jesus' way of the Passion this week. So rather than recording it, we invite you, if you're with others, to share the readings with each other, take turns doing the readings, or on your own. You may even read them aloud. And take time to reflect. Write in your journal. Share with your companions your reflections on the scripture, and do your own breaking open of the word today. Know that we will be we are praying for you and with you during these precious holy days of our church.